Hey, badass business owners. Back in the day when I was a district manager for Home Depot, I would go into stores and some would look really, really good and others would kind of be rough around the edges. And a lot of times what you have to look at is it the management team? Is it the leadership team? You know, what's causing this store to kind of not be as good as it can? Maybe it's not as profitable as it should. It's not doing the sales that it should. And just the overall feel of the store just is not right. And a lot of times what happened was the management was fine. The leadership was fine. It's just they had forgotten one of the core things that every business has to do. And that is return to basics, to never forget about the basics of your business. We used to call it getting back to basics. And I want to talk about that today because I had a great conversation this past week with a business owner and he was talking about some of the things that he was doing. And it really brought back my memories of the whole getting back to basics because that's what he was doing in his own business. And I'm like, wow, this is a great topic for us to talk about here. So what exactly is back to basics? Well, if you think about when you first started your business, there were things that you put in place to grow. Yes, you were throwing everything at the wall, but pretty soon you started realizing this works, this doesn't work. When I do this, I get this result. So you start putting in some core things that helped your business be very successful. And what happens is over time, we start trying all kinds of cool ideas to continue to grow our business. And as we try these different things and we tweak this and we tweak that and we go and do this, what happens is we slowly stop doing the basics of our business and we kind of lose sight of those. And next thing you know, we end up in a place that we, you know, we kind of didn't mean to end up in, but we kind of did. But then we turn around and look and we realize, wow, there's something wrong. Now, earlier, I mentioned that when I went into these stores, I could tell that they had lost their way when it came to the basics. The aisles were messy. They were out of stock. The people weren't saying hi, whatever the case may be. There was a whole laundry list of things we considered to be the basics of running your business. Just like in your business, there are basics that helped you do it as well. So what I want to do today is I want to talk about some core areas. And then what I want you to do is I want you to think about your business and what does that look like? What is the core foundation that should never change? And by the way, we see this in other businesses. McDonald's is great at this. They make it so simple. All you have to do is follow it. They're all about processes, right? And it's the basics. Now, whether they stick to them or not is why you'll see some McDonald's don't look as good as they should or the food or whatever. But there's gas stations out there. There's other businesses that have the same thing. And a lot of big box retailers use this in their business. And I think it's a great addition to your plan. And I highly recommend that you look at your basics at least once a quarter to see if you are in need of getting back to the basics. So first, let's take a look at customer service. What happens on customer service is when we start out, we're trying to give the best service that we could possibly give. Unfortunately, as we get busier, we start cutting out some of the things we used to do. Maybe in the beginning, we took a little bit of time. We listened a little bit more to what the customer or the client was saying, whatever the case may be. In a big box retailer, it could be that we told them to say hi to every single customer they came across. But as time goes on, they stop saying hi to everybody. And it's about time to get back to that core basic of just acknowledging people, which is huge. But customer service is more than just saying hi to people. Yes, it's also about treating them the right way, listening to them, trying to make sure you solve their problems and stuff like that. But customer service goes beyond that because when we think of customer service, it's are you able to find the things that you need to do? Now, that might be something as simple as your website. For example, is it easy to navigate or have you not even looked at it in so long that the customer is having this really bad experience when they're on there? Let's say you have a contact page on there. Do you even look to make sure that you're answering those messages that come through from your email? In some cases, I've had businesses where they never look at them. And then when I call them up and I'm like, hey, did you get that message? And they're like, oh, sorry, we don't ever look at those messages because it goes to something different. Or I didn't even realize it was broken and I wasn't getting those messages. So when you think customer service, think of all the aspects of when a customer is interacting with you in your business. Now, a huge piece of this is going to be communication. We just talked about email and are you getting back to them? But let's talk about phone calls as well. You're not expected to answer the phone every time someone calls, but you are expected to make sure they know you're going to call them back. And more importantly, you do. So do you have things in place that let them know, especially if you've gotten busier, like in the beginning, you were able to answer all those messages and now you can't? you can put something in place that says, hey, I will get back to you within the next 4 hours, or I'm tied up with a client. Even simple text messages on our phone nowadays. In my life, I have a couple different responses, and I tell people, hey, I'm with a client. I can't answer right now. Leave me a message. I have text message back. You know, tell people they can text message. I say I'm in a meeting or whatever the case may be. But do you have things in place that help communicate to the customer that they do matter, that they do, you do care about them, and that you're going to get back to them? So that's one, a big one, is customer service. And there's all kinds of other things that are tied under customer service. If you have a brick and mortar, what's the checkout system like? Can they get out of the store? That's a huge piece. How many times have you gone to the store and you feel like you're standing there forever and nobody's paying attention, or things are broken or things don't work? You know, once again, the checkout system. If you've got an online business, can they check out online? Or if you have a service-based business, and what's it like for them to check out and get you paid? Stuff like that. So make sure anything to do with customer service, that you are taking the time to step back and get back to the basics of customer service in your business. Now, I want to talk about in-stock. Not everybody has in-stock, but for a lot of you, if you use any kind of ingredients or materials or pieces or whatever the case may be, are you in stock? Think about that grocery store experience, that Home Depot, if you will, even, or any kind of big box retailer. There's nothing more frustrated than when you go to the shelf, you find the item that you want, and it's not in stock. And one, that goes back to the customer service. They have a really bad experience. But here's what also happens. You lose sales. Because most of the time when we're out of stock of something, it's usually not the item that you have 50 million of. Usually when you're out of stock, it's on one of your best sellers. It could be something that's a project starter, or it could be something that the customers really want and you just have not ordered enough. So getting back to basics is making sure it's in stock, it's on the shelf. Is it in the back? Is it in storage? Or are you just not ordering enough of this item that you need to do? And by the way, if you have parts and stuff on your truck, let's say you're a service-based business, same thing. That's still your inventory. Do you have it in stock? If a customer says, hey, can you do this as well? Can you actually do it if it's something you normally carry? Or is it something that you're going to have to go to a Home Depot or Lowe's or something to go get? But if it's something you normally carry, or maybe it's something you should carry, once again, get back to the basics on your inventory. Are you in stock? What does it look like, by the way? The displays, you know, there's nothing worse. Like, for example, some stores will have displays of stuff and they're all falling apart and they're dingy and they're breaking and everything else under the sun. That's not getting back to basics, because if you were getting back to basics, you would make sure that you had a fresh display, something that works, that people can touch, or whatever the case may be. So when you're thinking about in stock and you're thinking about your inventory, are you ordering enough? Do you have it on the shelf if that's the case? Do you have it in your truck like you're supposed to? Just think about that whole vision of what in-stock means to your particular business. Which leads me to general maintenance. General maintenance is, what do they look like? Earlier I talked about the fact that if you have displays, what do they look like? General maintenance could be the uniform, if you wear one, or if your employees wear them. What do those look like? General could be your vehicles. Are they clean? Are they crisp? They don't have to be perfect, because it is all the time. But if the last time you got that vehicle washed was like 5-6 months ago and it is just caked in dirt, ask yourself, is that the way that you want to present yourself to your customers? I get that you've been busy and it's just been the last thing. But once again, getting back to the basics, I'm pretty sure that if you thought about what your business was going to look like, it wasn't going to be one that is showing up in a really dirty truck. Unless, of course, you deal with sewage or something that's just dirty, then people are going to be more understanding. But if you're coming in to clean their carpets and your truck is filthy, how much do you think that they're going to think that you're going to bring that filth into their store? When I had my ice cream shop, for example, I used to tell people that I wanted the lobby to be clean and I wanted behind the counters where the ice cream was to be clean. Because if my lobby was dirty, the first thought that somebody's going to have is, how dirty is it behind the scenes? If it's dirty out here where the customer is, I can only imagine how dirty it is behind the counter and how dirty it is in the back room. And we've all been to places that are like that. I've pulled up to places and I'm just like, going, this place is disgusting, and I can tell that it's probably going to be just as disgusting behind those counters. I remember going into some fast food place and I was giving my order or something, and I'm looking at the floor and you could tell that it had not been mopped in forever and a day, and it was filthy. And then that just got me thinking, going, I'm pretty sure that where the food is, it's pretty disgusting as well. And I ended up leaving. It was that bad. I mean, I can put up with a lot of stuff, especially after busyness, but these people were standing around and the place was just filthy. So I knew everything else was going to be filthy. So ask yourself, what does your cleaning look like in your maintenance? And do you need to go back and you need to look at things and help bring that piece up as well? One of the big ones is your procedures. And this is a lot of the conversation I had the other day is a lot of times we have procedures in place and they work. That's why you created those procedures. But over time, once again, we're trying different things. We bring in new people. They want to try their things, whatnot. And all of a sudden we forget about things that we used to do that were really keeping us on track of a lot of things we did. Maybe they were checklists, maybe they were maintenance lists. A popular one, I'll just use this one, is sometimes you've gone into a bathroom of someplace and there's this list on the back of the door that tells you how often they clean it. And I don't know about you, but I look at it because there's some people that are doing it on the regular and you can see the sign-offs on it and the bathroom looks great. And then other times the bathroom will look horrible and you'll go look at that list and the last time it was done was like 3 months ago. They forgot this basic item that they used to do, which is what would keep their bathrooms clean. So if they would just get back to basics and using the form and the checklist, their bathrooms would look much better. You can use these things everywhere in your business and just ask yourself, are there things that you used to do that really helped you stay on target? And have you forgotten about them? Have you wavered from them? Are you no longer doing them? Ask yourself, which items do you need to revisit so you can get back to basics? What are those basics for you when it comes to your procedures in your business? Now, it wouldn't be a video from me if I also didn't talk about your numbers. And you know that you need to know your numbers. I'm not going to preach on that. But what I'm going to tell you is, I'm going to bet when you first started your business, you were aware of every dime that was coming into your business. Why? Because you were trying to get the business off the ground. And in some cases, it was a fight for survival. So you knew how much came in, you knew what you had to pay out in bills, and you knew exactly what you needed, you were going to be able to put into your pocket. But here's what happens. As we get busier and busier and busier, and we're not as living off of every little inch of what we make, we stop paying attention to those numbers. Now, I'm a firm believer that you need to dive into those numbers. You need to have good bookkeeping. You need to be able to understand your P&L and you need to be able to read them. I'm not diverting from that at all. All I'm saying is a lot of you have gotten so lazy that not only are you not doing that piece, you're not even paying attention to what you are bringing in and what is going out. If I just ask you, what did you do in sales? You can't even answer that basic question. If I ask you how much you spent last month, you don't have an idea. If I ask you what your expenses are, you don't have an idea. But I'll guarantee you, in the very beginning of your business, you knew, hey, I've got $1,000 in expenses that I've got to cover every single month, or I need to make X amount of money in order to be able to survive. You knew that, but something happens on your journey where you go from knowing it to not knowing it to back to knowing it. And to me, that's one of those basics, is really understanding your business numbers. So maybe not at the level that I would want you to be, but are you at least at the basics of knowing your sales, knowing what your costs run, knowing what your expenses are, and about what your profit is? And are you making sure that you're setting aside taxes from the profit that you're making in your business? Those are just basics. That's the basic minimum that you need to have and understand for your business. Are you even doing that? Now, I know I talked a lot today about the basics. The basics are different to every single person, but I can tell you, customer service is a basic for everybody. Procedures in your business, systems, is a basic for everybody. How you present yourself, the cleaning, the maintenance, and everything else is a basic for everybody. Making sure that people can communicate with you and you can communicate back, whether it's your Google Business page, your website, your Facebook page, whatever you use, that's a basic of your business. And understanding your sales and where your money's going is a basic of your business. So what I'm asking you is to just take a pause, take a step back and ask yourself, what are the basics of your business that you have lost your way on? And can you put them back in place? Because typically when someone gets back to basics, everything goes up. Earlier, I talked about those stores when I would go in and we would need to get them back on basics. Guess what happened? You got it. The minute they got back to basics and they really focused on the core things of their business, their stores got better. Their sales went up. Their in-stock went up, which got them more sales. Their customer service went up, which made happier customers, which got them to come back more often. Their pride went up in the store because they were taking better care of the store. The sales went up because happy employees do even better. So when we get back to basics, that's the baseline of your store. That's the foundation of your business And you need to make sure that for your business, that your foundation is always strong. And those are the basics of your business. And I want to challenge you to step back and ask yourself, have you lost your way? And do you need to get back to basics? And if you like what we talked about today, make some comments down below, hit that subscribe button, that like button, all that good stuff, and check out these, I never remember, check out the video over here and learn some more about your business. I'm here to help you out. All right. I'll talk to you on the next episode. Bye for now.